I suggest we start we're back at our headquarters after a DNF finish at Zandvoort. 311 R&D points. Can't do anything with that. We are unfortunately in the middle of the pack as far as vehicle performance. And haven't been getting upgrades as much as the other teams. But hopefully they'll come in soon. $3 million in the bank. As far as facilities goes, we'll probably do absolutely nothing because we will have to save. Work the week as well, so we'll do some weight training, advanced time.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process.
Chassis, facility, we'll have upgraded the spec 3. Other than that, nothing much else to do, so I will see you guys at Monza.
A difficult race awaits these drivers here in Monza, but glory awaits too, at the Italian Grand Prix. With top speeds reaching 215 miles per hour, only a few places can challenge Monza's crown as the fastest track in Formula One. Hard braking zones going into the three chicanes make up the majority of the 11 corners on this 3.6-mile circuit. And just in case the slipstream wasn't enough, two DRS zones will help encourage some close action. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. A fantastic effort from Pierre Gasly yesterday puts him on pole position, and the smooth operator Carlos Sainz completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Ocon, Verstappen, Fernando Alonso, Norris, Perez, Albon, Russell, Stroll, Hamilton, Bottas, Tsunoda, Oscar Piastri, Joe, Sargent, De Vries, Armstrong, Magnussen, Senna, and King. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, How do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into Turn 1, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It will keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Here we go then. The formation lap gets underway and the excitement here is building as we near ever closer to the start of the race. Which team will come out on top? Who's got their strategies right for today's race? Well, we'll soon find out. As the cars come back towards the grid to line up for the start of the race, each driver will be wanting to get the best start they possibly can. And they'll be hoping to finish today's race on the podium, failing that within the points.
Right, let's focus now for the rest of the race. DRS is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Okay, the car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap starting to form. Battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. Okay, you're in the top 10. Right, we need to get past here. Use overtake. Caution! Green flag, we're racing again, let's go! Approaching the pit window, and you're going to be on mediums. Okay, be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon. Okay, some information on Piastri. Okay, clear. We're going to box this lap and push hard on the inlap. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 6.8 seconds. Okay, mate, that's it. Go, go, go. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Got a lot of spare energy, okay to use your overtake button. Ayrton's coming in for his stop now. Okay, keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 4.2 seconds. Okay, push, push. Gap to the car behind. 8.9 seconds. Good job, that was the fastest lap of the race so far. behind you's just come in for the hard tyres. Car behind, running hard tyres. Okay, the incident's been cleared. Let's get back up to racing speed. Come on. Okay, so the gap to the car ahead, 2.3 seconds. Try and close the gap to the car ahead. It's currently 2 seconds up the road. Okay, Russell's behind you now. Okay, car behind trailing us, 3.7 seconds. Okay, they're on fresh hards, and the time last lap was a 1:40.8. You've lost some time to the car behind. Russell behind. Okay, gap to the car behind. Car behind. 3.7 seconds. Okay, they're on fresh hards. Their tyres are 2 laps old. Your last lap time was a 1 minute 20.9. Lando's ahead of you now, and gap to the car in front is 1.9 seconds. Okay, they're on fresh hards. Their tyres are 2 laps old. Time last lap was a 1:21.1. Okay, gap ahead is 1.8 seconds. Car ahead, well done, but be aware these tyres need to get us to the end of this race. Gap to your teammate behind is 19.3 seconds. gap to the car in front is 2.6 seconds. Tire concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving. Ahead. Okay, gaps of the car ahead is 2.3 seconds. Okay, they're on old hard tyres. Their tyres are 11 laps old now, and the time last lap was a 1 minute 22.0. We're gaining by around 0.2 per lap. Keep going. And that's just 5 laps of fuel remaining. Okay, here's the gap that we're trailing the car ahead by, 1.8 seconds. Gap on the car behind by 0.5 a lap. Okay, mate, final lap. Keep your concentration and let's bring it home. Okay, good work. Great pass. Right, we've got enough fuel for 3 more laps. All right, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
There it is then, victory in the Italian Grand Prix. An historic race and an achievement they can be immensely proud of. And talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Looking at the podium, you can see that red suit familiar to fans across the globe. A world-class win for a world-class team. Ferrari, do it again.
Alright, and here we have Carlos Sainz P1, Charles Leclerc P2, Esteban Ocon P3. We finished P7 on the day after starting P22. Could have gone P5 there at the end if it wasn't for that 5-second penalty. This was my first race back in my team using a controller after being so used to, well, after getting used to using a wheel and driving an F2. Also, I'm not sure why my car was kind of topping out or hitting the rev limiter in eighth gear down the straight so fast and for so long. Don't know if it's because I had new components or something weird with the game. But I don't think that's what slowed me down. I think it's just me trying to get used to using the controller again after being so used to the wheel now. I tried using the wheel here, but I just wanted to continue using a controller just because I've been using a controller for this My Team series for so long. But P7, after starting far in the back and getting used to, can't complain, so it is what it is, and we'll try to get back into form in the next race.